you all for showing up today. This meeting is going to be expressly about the mayor's new decree for 360-degree evaluations. My hope during this time period is to convince you individually to invest yourself in the movement, to model the behaviors, and as well to be a champion for this cause. I believe in it. I hope that you will too. And not just to follow along because the boss said so. For myself, when I received this news that this is the way it's going to be, I started thinking, well, why do I personally care about this 360-degree evaluations? What's broken? Well, you know my background is in energy efficiency. And yet, at the same time, the words of a social justice icon come to my mind. Martin Luther King Jr. said, "Nothing in the world is more dangerous than sincere ignorance and conscientious stupidity." Those are some pretty heavy words to reflect on. He also said, "Our lives begin to end the day we become silent about things that matter." And I thought about this in this context, and I realized that we have not only become silent in some ways, but we've institutionalized silence by wedding ourselves to an evaluation system that is linear, that is top-down, and that doesn't listen to the input of all of our people. It's a flawed system, it's a fragile system, and it is an inefficient system. So today I'll present where we are today, the proposed concept, and some of the benefits that it's going to deliver. And yes, it will be a call to action. So where are we now today? Well, we've got the standard old school system of evaluations, where once a year somebody, and that somebody is one specific person, a person's supervisor delivers an evaluation on how that person did during the entire year, as though that supervisor has the monopoly on wisdom and also sees enough of that person to properly evaluate them and affect their future career fundamentally in that assessment. That person doesn't exist. I certainly don't hold that degree of wisdom or vision on any of my employees or my direct reports. I'm pretty sure none of you either do either. But what has it gotten us, this system? One would say, oh, it's efficient, it's quick. Well, it's gotten us 14% engagement, true engagement of our personnel utility-wide. There's one division that has 4% engagement of their people. That's not efficient. Close your eyes, or keep your eyes open. No, keep them open, because I'm going to act out. That is, by the numbers, the same thing as if our beloved Seahawks were playing the big playoff game and the entire offensive line was replaced by high school players, except for Russell Wilson. Wilson, our glorious quarterback. He takes the snap. He drops back 6-7 yards. He's eyeing downfield. He reaches in his pocket, takes a little selfie, and then gets hammered by the defense. That's what 4% is. That is not an efficient team. There's also claims, and this is most disturbing to me, of unfair hiring practices where people, managers, for example, may hire among the pool of candidates someone who's not the best candidate, but someone that they know will have their back and who knows that the manager will always give them a good review no matter how badly they perform. Well, that's kind of like going to Coach Carroll, right, and saying, did you see that? He just, the quarterback just got completely plowed. And the coach says, well, you know, I didn't see it that way. I say that we're winning. We are so killing it. We're going to the Super Bowl, baby. It doesn't jive. It doesn't line up, right? Because it's not real. It's not the whole story. So here's our proposal. 360-degree evaluations. What is it? In a nutshell, you already know. It's not a single person evaluating you. It's your supervisor, yes. Also, your team, your staff. Also, your peers. So that we get a more complete picture of what's really going on. What are our strengths? What are our weaknesses? It's very simple. And what are some of the benefits? There's benefits in terms of efficiency, but also on the social justice tap as well. Yes, on the efficiency side, we will have a more complete picture. We know what we're doing right. We will know. And we'll know what isn't working, so we can focus on that. We can find strong performers, managers who are good at time management. Well, that's really good. Could that person be a coach? You bet. And we'll single them out to provide that knowledge, that wisdom, in that competency to others so that we can all gain from that. And those built, improved needs that we're going to be bringing to the table are going to be noticed. Everything we do as leaders is seen and taken note of. On the social justice side, there is something miraculous that happens when people who have not been heard are heard. They are given the dignity of having something worth saying. And what does it mean? What happens? They become more engaged. They come up with ideas where they kind of had shut down before. They're better ideas. There's less conflict. There are less people taking sick time unnecessarily. Is that a more efficient operation? Again, we're back to efficiency. So here's my call to action. My call to action today is for myself. We begin by you evaluating me to establish a baseline. We'll do this by the end of the week. I'll send out the survey to each of you, and we'll get it back. I'm going to be available to give questions. This is going to be very open because we're building something new. You can hit me with questions during the week, before your evaluation, after your evaluation, and then afterward we can tune it together as we look at what we're going to roll out to your own divisions. Change is hard, and people are going to have some difficulty taking it on. I already have some ideas for some rewards to offer people, including lunch for the first division that has all of them completed. So, you've heard my position and my decision. By next week, it's going to be your turn to decide. Will you invest? Will you model? Will you be an intrepid champion? It's up to you. Martin Luther King also said, freedom is never voluntarily given by the oppressor. It must be demanded by the oppressed. I would like myself and everyone in this room to turn that on its head. Let's step out and give that freedom, give that ear, so that we